Tonight, Travis cooks a hooker. Max isn't here.
Max.
And Alex blows and whistles.
So, welcome to East Haddam, Connecticut. This is the campaign event for the More Steam for Connecticut campaign. Fuck you, Ned Lemoy Mark II Electric Boogaloo. I hope you die in a giant bus accident with a gas tanker and all kinds of horrible toxic waste. But anyway, so this, reviving a little bit of the productive side of Connecticut, this is a Farquhar Overtype engine. It consists of a boiler, an engine, and we call it an Overtype because the engine's on top, and Undertype, the engine would be underneath. Simple machine. It's a locomotive boiler, single cylinder engine with a slide valve. There's no reversing gear or anything like that. Little governor up there with no belt on it as of yet. This way?
Yeah, it needs to move this way.
How about that?
More? Yeah, oh, we got it.
Nice. Is there a locking pin on the other side?
We got a pin for that.
Yep.
Okay, hold on.
Firebox in. Bang that side. There you go.
That might have done it. Straight away.
Nope.
Yeah. Take like that.
Use this.
This is a horrible abuse on tools. Do we have a real hammer?
I mean, it is, yeah.
Let me take a look.
Oh, yeah, it's almost there.
Yeah, we just...
Are you using the adjustable hammer?
$45 US gallons. Yeah, right. Well, no, 42.
In form, living in the sunlight, loving in the moonlight, having a wonderful time.
All right, shut up.
Haven't got a lot. I don't need a lot. Coffee's only $1.25.
You know, at the gas station where I got my food, I was tempted to buy the fireworks that were there.
Oh, it's awful murky.
Yeah. I mean, we didn't rinse them out.
Why don't you just turn the hose on and let it overflow?
Light, you bastard.
Phil, just... Wow, man.
Phil, you're shaming yourself, man. You can't light the lighter?
He does that a lot.
You can't light
there
the rag.
You actually have a flame?
No.
I got flames.
Can't fly.
Ready for this? That's lit. That's lit.
First fire in, 40 years or something?
Probably.
Yes.
We should have somebody in the box when that happened.
Max.
I do enjoy some of Connecticut's fine coal-fired pizza. Just a little bit less on the mold, though. Unfortunately, unlike the rest of the world, I don't like a cold fucking pizza!
Okay, steam on, we gotta trim it. It's primed itself, the water's in it. Might not have enough steam.
Yeah, you don't have enough steam.
Yeah, not enough steam pressure. We'll try the Metropolitan. Oh-ho! Metropolitan works!
We got a nice leak there, though.
Yeah, we do. We'll tighten that up. Shut it off.
Yep. Yeah. Because our fire is still going and we're not using any steam right now.
Yeah. Not yet. I need to hear it.
Okay.
Hello, my name is Tremendous Travis. As you can see here, we're cooking our dead hooker in here.
Yep.
Ah, Violet seems to be cooking along nicely. Should be about medium well.
I don't think you have any control. I think it's going to be well done, man.
Well done, boy.
Aye, aye.
That is
a good first startup. Very good.
Our sight glass, not the best quality fittings. We centered the glass. We tried both the rubber packing nuts it came with and graphite yarn. It refuses to seal up at all. See, both nuts continue to leak. So rather than have the glass shatter, we're running it the way we ran steam engines in the 1830s, just tricocks. They're more reliable than that anyway. This is an interesting boiler. We got a fire door for coal, which is if you have a really shallow fire bed, and then a fire door for wood and other refuse like tires, children, whatever you want to burn in there.
Dead hookers.
This is a very nice, smooth engine. It's a pretty high-speed engine. We can't run it at full RPM right now because the engine is not on a solid base and we'll shake the chimney loose and a bunch of other things. We got a Metropolitan lifting injector on this side, a Penberthy on the other side, which doesn't seem to be behaving itself. We suspect the cones got scored during a cleaning attempt years ago, but we don't know. You mean the Met? The one that works, yeah. So to start a lifting injector, basically, provided it's cool, it's going to suck its water up into its own body by Venturi. That's priming. And then when the water hits the steam collapses very rapidly, which adds more steam velocity, and the injector can then go to forcing, which is putting water in the boiler. Prime it.
Like so.
Now it's feeding, and you can hear it in the check valve. If this check valve, for any reason, refused to close, the water would come back through the injector overflow and out of the boiler, so you can shut it with this isolator if you have to. Same thing on the other side. That's a safety valve right there. This opens automatically when the boiler pressure gets up to the set point that you don't want it going over. That's been tested, that works. These drain lines, they just drain condensate out of the steam engine when you're warming it up, because of course if the piston compresses a water slug, you may blow a head off. Drip oilers, there are grease fittings that you crank down on the main rod, small and big end. Oil cellar type main bearings on the shaft, it's just a pool of oil with a wick. And you can belt drive anything you want off of these wheels.
Hookers?
Whatever you want. You can drive they have these machines now, I guess they're called puppy mills. There's a lubricator there. That works by being driven off the reciprocating motion of the engine. There's a little high pressure pump in there that forces oil into the steam line, which can then lubricate the various internal pieces in the valve and piston. The governor up there, you see there's a board propping up a pulley. That's a Pickering governor.
Well, that's true.
And what it works is it's basically a small analog computer, really, but works on the principle of the faster the engine goes, the faster the balls spin.
And pizza.
The faster the balls are spinning, centrifugal force pulls them out, which varies the position of a valve underneath, automatically controls the speed of the engine. There's an added feature where if the belt were to snap on that governor and it stopped, of course the engine would have no speed governing anymore and it would run away. The safeguard against this is if the belt snaps, that pulley wheel we have propped up drops down and trips the steam valve closed as a safety device. So for all the people that didn't think we were very safety conscious 130 years ago, we were. And that's one of the many safety features of steam engines.
It's not that good.
There's not really much else to tell because it's such a simple machine, but we have whistles that we brought. So I think our friend here is going to demonstrate the Connecticut Symphony Orchestra.
This one came off a drawbridge. I don't know where this one came from, but it's Braden's. That's a Powell. The big one is American Steam Gauge and Valve Company. And then this one here is mine. Well, that one's mine too, but this one is, if you have a road engine or a ship or some steam-driven vehicle that can move itself, if you take this whistle to the beach when there's lots of beautiful women around,